HOK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
It's a framework, extensible frameworks. Whenever we are working on a framework, framework make our work easier. So whenever there is a standard framework we work with, it can be anything. It can be Struts 1, Struts 2, Cricket, Spring, anything. Okay. So those frameworks are basically makes your work much easier. I'll send that. Okay. We can schedule, I'll send it. Okay. So Apache Struts 2 is an intelligent extensible framework for creating enterprise ready Java applications. Okay. The framework is designed to streamline the full development cycle from building, deploying and maintaining applications over time. So what makes our life easier is standardization. So it has a standard way of doing things. Okay. Whenever we have a problem in the flow, we know where to look at. Okay. So that's what the framework does for us. Otherwise, what will happen, like every developer having a different experience will create different kind of classes and structures and ultimately end up in very complicated kind of structure of a Java program or structure of that application. Okay, the person who is at 4 years experience do not do layered architecture and do not use business objects properly and do not use design patterns, but the person with 10 years experience use everything. And ultimately project is gonna suffer. That's kind of stuff generally is easily removed by the use of frameworks. So frameworks actually is already a building block and you just have to put the bricks into it. Okay. So Struts 2 is first created by Jakarta. The license was from Jakarta. There was a company and then later it was converted to Apache license, okay, open source license. So previous books of Struts, you can see that's named as Jakarta Struts. Later it was Struts 2, Struts 1 can be, the books are also mentioning at Apache Struts. For Struts 2 is completely Apache, okay. So Apache is a open source license provider, if you don't know about it already. What is this Struts 2? Struts 2 is MVC framework. Okay, it follows MVC, standard MVC. Model View Controller or MVC is a popularly called as a software design pattern for developing web applications. Model View Controller pattern is made up of following three parts. Okay, first part is model classes. It's the lowest level of the pattern which is responsible for maintaining data. Okay, in Struts at least we will make sure that we will use model word for data maintainers, right? DTOs, model classes. Okay. Then there is a view responsible for viewing data, and for Struts purpose, for understanding Struts, we will make sure we use view for JSPs, controller software code that controls the interaction. Now this is where it gets complicated. Controller is two parts in Struts 2. Okay. So one part of controller is XML, another part of controller is a Java class. Okay. So combination of XML and Java class, that is also called as action class. Okay, our repeaters might have known that XML and action class together creates a controller. Okay, we do have some other kind of controllers, or we will also call it that filters called as interceptors. Okay, those are also considered as controllers sometimes. Okay, but the real controllers of Struts are XML and action classes, and we're gonna see the details of it. So it's gonna have a similar XML like Spring. Okay. And we will also use some of the properties, very similar property like beans we used in Spring. So very similar things in here also, and it is much easier than that. Okay. Model responsible for managing data, view, presentation layer. We know that JSP, ASP, PHP kind of stuff. Controller. Okay. Controller is responsible for responding the user input and perform interactions on the data model objects. The controller receives the input, it validates the input, then performs the business operation that modifies the state of data model. So what are the components? Okay, so let's jot down the components one by one and we'll categorize them in different things. Okay, so first thing is action. that is action class. Okay, section class is a class, basically a simple class, which now you can have two different ways of creating an action class. You can have an interface. We have two different ways anyway. Just like thread, we have runnable and thread. Okay, here also we can have an action interface or action support class. Class to extend an action interface. So these are two different ways you create an action class. Okay, we're gonna see why, how, okay, what exactly it does. As of now, just try to understand this is what action class means. When you implement action interface or when you extend action support and instructs to, regardless whether you do both these things, you can create an action class without these two also. Okay, so that is a property of struts2. We're gonna see that. Second thing is struts XML. This is also part of, okay, I'll just write it here, part of controller logic. Struts XML is also part of controller logic. And what does exactly do? It will actually configure your URL to action mapping. Who does that for us in servlets? Who does this configuration to your URL to your action, or what exactly you're doing? Is that right? Anybody? Quick guess. Then we have interceptors, web.xml. Yeah, that's right answer. Web.xml does that. Okay, URL to servlet mapping. Then interceptors, create interceptors if required using existing interceptors. This is a part of controller again. So see here, it's actually wrote as a part of controller. I told you that. So the third point is interceptors. Interceptor intercepts the request. This is similar to servlet filters. Okay. View. JSP. Actual view. JSP page. And then what else we have? This is it. Okay. We do have something called as value stack. Okay. That's something we will discuss once we complete our Hello World example. Okay. Let me write it here. Value stack. And this is to migrate data between layer. Okay, this is not a part of any model view or controller. That's why it's not mentioned here, but it's an important part of struts. So these are five important components. First is action, then struts XML, interceptors, view. And now let's try to configure these objects properly into a Hello World example and see what are the things you can see with the help of struts. It's super easy, super awesome. You will enjoy that. Okay. So let's understand the steps. Create an action class by implementing action interface or extending action support class. Okay. Create a view, which is JSP. Set up a configuration file, struts.xml. Okay. So if, I think we can do it from scratch. There is no harm in doing that. I grab this all. So let's create a dynamic web project. Okay, and then I'll just say that it's a March struts. I don't have any already existing March struts from 2015, it seems. Cool, and just finish it off. Oh, structs, struts, rename. Okay. Now the first thing I'll do is I'll create a package and I'll create an action class. Package. whenever we hit a URL from that JSP, something should happen. Okay, that's something we need to configure. H2K. Struts. This is my package. And my first class is hello action. Okay. To implement action, I need library files. I'm just grabbing it from another project. I can give you an entire set of jar files from Struts. Okay, and I'll also give you where to download those. Cookies. Just refresh. Jar files, once you put in lib, you don't have to actually find. Now it makes sense. It's pretty faster. Good. Is it good now? Yeah, my computer was hung. Okay. Now how can I create with the help of implements? Action. There is something seriously wrong with my Eclipse today. Action. And you can see that class is com.opensymphony.xwork2. This is what the struts is. Okay. You will not see the jar files like com.struts.something. Okay. The project is OpenSymphony. Okay. And xwork2. I'm good with it. Import that. Once you have action class, once you implement action, you need to have single method. That single method is execute method. Not sure when that pop-up gonna come. So this method is important. This method is coming from this action class execute. Will get executed once hello action is okay. So this is you have a servlet and you have do get and do post method. Okay. So you have action, you will have execute method. Okay. And whatever you write in execute method is basically what business logic. Okay, so from here you can call your business objects, from here you can call your DAO directly. That's not recommended though. It's a controller, so it should call business object, then business object should call DAO. Whatever action on business happens here and then come back to the result. So whatever logic we are running here, we will just call business logic. Okay, and then return a string. That string actually represents what kind of things you want to do, whether that particular request is successful, whether it is an erroneous situation, whether it's a fault, whether you have to send it back. So you have some already defined strings inside this action class. You can see that there is a defined string called success, none, error, input. There is a specific use of input and login. There is a use of login also. Login means go back to the login, it's not authenticated. Okay, so we're gonna use this guy. We are already implementing this particular interface. We are good. Directly use this word. Is there any problem with audio? Still facing problem? Unfortunately, I am seeing the audio bars as completely occupied, so it's a full volume. So if you are facing audio issues, then probably we need to restart or something. I'm not sure because there is nothing from this end I can do. It's fine now. I'm not sure what's happening today. Okay. So from that particular action class, we're gonna use some words, already existing words, to return the response. Okay. That is success, none, error, and input. So as of now, I'm not using error. I'm just using success. We will use error in the later situation. So I'm just grabbing that word as it is, grabbing that variable name as it is and putting it. I can use it directly as I implement action. And this is it. This is my actual action class. So this actually works. Okay. How did you get passed from this UI? How do we pass the probably by today or tomorrow we'll have that our request and will be yeah. Now second thing we have to do is map this thing to the URL. So that's a